Hi, my name's Rich, WB5YBZ, and I've put a full wave loop. It's sort of a stealth antenna. I'm in a HOA, no antennas of any kind. So let's just go over here and just see what it looks like from the street view. So you can just sort of see it. I'm going to stand in the middle of the street of our addition. The bad thing is my antenna is the back of the row that comes in and out of the addition, so everybody can go by and see it, which makes it a little creepy. But let's just say you're driving down the road. Now let me flip this around. Okay, can you see any wires? No. So you're just driving down this way. You're looking at the road. You see nothing. Unless you just really look. Let's go on the backyard and see what it looks like. Okay, I'm using a Ballon Designs. It's 2.5. A 2.5 Ballon. Now I just want to show you, there's two wires, of course, as you can see. I'm going to back up here. What I did is I just had one of the wires from one side of the Ballon to come up. I'm thinking that's probably 10 feet to the birdhouse here. Now if you follow this wire, and you got to get the light just right, or you really don't see it. I think it was number 16 wire. I have 55 feet over, I'm sorry, yeah, about 55 feet over, I have a birdhouse. And it's about 20 feet high. And then, as you can see, I have another insulator separating the wire there. Now, coming on along, if you look over there, there's another birdhouse about 22 feet high. And let me just sort of walk over there. So this is the second, or I guess I'd say the third birdhouse, is about 70 feet or something like that. The bad thing about this is you can see, the wire coming down, and it might interact with the telescopic pole, which might suck up your signal, I'm not sure. But I have it coming down almost to the bottom of this roof here, see? And it's separated. I try to pull it. It's about a foot away from the pole. And then you see that insulator. Well, let's go back of the shed here. Why I'm showing you this is I just want you to get an idea. I don't have any room in my backyard, but it's sort of L-shape. It's probably 110. Now, I'm not sure if you can see where it goes, but see, the metal shed probably interacts with the antenna, which isn't good. But I have it coming down this way on this fence, which is about 5 feet, 5.5 feet, and it goes down to where the corner is, which I have an insulator. Right there's the insulator. And then I thought, well, let's put a little height on it. So I went back up to the sort of 10 feet down from the telescopic pole. You can see the insulator there. Then I have it coming down. I hope you don't mind me showing you this slow process. It's sort of taking up room, trying to take up a little slack so when we mow we won't get our heads hit. So I put it between the fence to the insulator and over here to the Ballon Design 2.5 Ballon. Now with the metal poles there could be some absorption to the shed, there could be some absorption. According to Ballon Design, if you have a full wave loop up horizontally, you have about 40 feet or higher, you have a 6 to 8 dB gain. But I know a full wave loop, and this is a full wave loop, I had to add eight, I had to put eight more feet than suggested. I think I cut it for 250, and I have it about 257 or 58 feet long to bring the SWR in. You'll just have to adjust it. But let's go in and see what the radio, the ICOM 7300 shows on its scale on the SWR. And I want to thank you for watching. Here's 80 meters. So you can see the higher the frequency, it's going to really go out. It's probably pretty good in the CW portion of the band, or the upper portion of the CW portion of the band. But all in all, this antenna is a really good antenna. All right, let's look and see how 40 does. As you can tell, I have a low wattage, but you can tell the SWR is not bad at all for 40 meters. Let's go on up to the next band. Let's look at 17 meters. Not bad. Here is 15 meters. It's pretty well flat. Meters. And this is 10 meters and it's not very good at all. For some reason it's very good. How about 6 meters. As you can see, 6 meters a little bit low. Let's change a little bit high. Let's change this to 10 kilohertz. Well, the 10 kilohertz step shows it's a little under 3, but still awful high.
Here's 20 meters. Not bad.